CUNY, but we are lucky to be in this really legendary New York, Lower East Side location. Please do look it up. Not only Allen Ginsberg, many, many others in the original cafe. You're going to rent their work in this place, so it's very dear to us. And it's one of the few spaces we feel left that make New York, New York, and Manhattan, and the scene, what makes it so different and exciting. My name is Frank Henschkin. I'm the director of the Siegel Center. We had the great privilege to be part of PEN, World Voices. It's the great festival of the PEN Writers Organization, one of the greatest organizations I admire. They do combine literature and human rights activities. They give us the most significant awards you can get, and they also get writers out of prison and help people who are still in there. So please follow their work and become a member if you are a writer. The festival is 1 week. It's coming to the close. I think today is the last day. Over 80 writers, great writers from around the world, are in the city right now and sharing their voices and their views. It has been created by Paul Auster, Salman Rushdie, Michael Roberts, and others during the first years of the Bush government, where they felt the tunnel vision of the American government is really not what could be accepted. Compared to now, I think it's even more significant of what we hear. 95% of all books, and Penn always asked me to say that, 95% of the books that are you can get in any bookshop here are from the English-writing countries. 5% that's left, half of it is German or French because it's subsidized. Only 2 or 3 out of those 100 books come from around the world. Just imagine you're a musician and you would only listen to what happens in your own country or to 1 or 2 others. It would be unacceptable and would be in the way of development, your own view of the world and artistic creation. So we are doing our share here, and we listen to voices from all around the world. And we had here great writers from Australia, from the Ukraine, from Turkey, and Brazil, from Guinea, from Germany, Syria, Palestine. And now we come to a play from a country we hear a lot about, but we don't really hear voices from there, from South Korea. And one of the things also is the relations between those two countries. So we are very, very excited to hear this and to hear how it's put into a dramatic form. Also, how do the playwrights do it? What's the craft? And also, how do the directors do it here on this small stage? And how will the actors give you their story? So the play is called Sister Mung Nam. And the writer is Un Song Kim. And where is he here?
Right here.
So he came to us. The translator is Dayong Jong, is he? And directed by Sunjae Kim. Also, in Mexican, but also they still talk to each other, which is normally a good sign after this. So this actually concludes our brilliant 3 days we had. We have the place available in case there's any interest. Or if you really would like to thank our Siegel Center team, the producer, Brooke, and my co-curator, Antje Oegel, Soraya Chum, who was an assistant curator, Brad and Michael at the keyboards, and Bella and Rebecca, and so many, many others who I will forget now who would name that we have, Alba, and everybody else from the Siegel Center, please, it wouldn't have been possible. Also, again, the Penn World Voices for letting us collaborate with them. We really highly do respect their work. We have a celebratory drink afterwards, so I hope you will stay here. The American Poets Cafe agreed as an exception to keep the bar open, so please go have a drink, talk to the artists and the writers. And if you have a cell phone, please do take it out. I'll do the same. And find that little switch where it says off. I'll do the same. Here. Again, so right now, Sister Mung Nam. Thank you. Thank you.
Sister Mong Nan, written by Eunsong Kim, translated by Taeyong Chong. Time, today. Setting, various corners in the Republic of Korea, South Korea, and the Democratic Republic of Korea, North Korea. Characters, Cho Mong Nan. South Korean female, 55, room salon owner in Seoul. Ho Tae-san, South Korean male, 36, PhD in Korean history, unemployed, Cho Dae-ja's eldest son. Ho Tae-gang, South Korean male, 33, college professor, Cho Dae-ja's younger son. Ho Tae-young, South Korean female, 30, novelist, Cho Dae-ja's youngest child. Ho Se-byul, South Korean female, 9, elementary school student. Kim Jong-il, North Korean male, 41, member of an anti-North Korean organization and North Korean refugee broker living in South Korea. Oh Yong-kwon, South Korean male, 48, film director. Kang Guk-sik, Korean American male born in Tokyo, 66, businessman living in LA. Cho Sun-ho, North Korean male, 55, painter, Cho Mong Nan's father. Bae Myung Hee, North Korean female, 30, member of an organization for reunification, folk singer living in South Korea. Yuk Sun Yong, South Korean female, 33, elementary school teacher. Song Hong Yong, North Korean female, 15, middle school student. Nam Yure, South Korean female, 21, room salon escort. Hwan Du-sung, South Korean female, 23, college student. Ri Myung-cho, North Korean male, 32, North Korean defector who returned to North Korea. Kook Sang-chul, South Korean male, 32, assistant to a congressman. Hyun Sung-wook, South Korean male, 34, secretary of a South Korean conglomerate company. Chung Shin-kyun, South Korean male, 34, doctor. Seo Hyung-dor, South Korean male, 25, college student. Chun Won-sang, South Korean male, 20, pizza delivery guy. Yoo Mong-nan, North Korean female, 10. Prologue, pandemonium in the Korean Peninsula. Cho Sun-ho is drawing a portrait of Kim Il-sung upstage with his back towards the audience. And Ho Tae-san is downstage, staring at the audience. Seoul, North Korea, auditorium, festival for the Union of Displaced Parents. Cho Mong-nan and Bae Myung-hee in thick makeup and colorful hanbok sing a North Korean pop song.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Comrades, brothers, let us grab our cordial hands. With our steadfast yearning, reunification draws nigh. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Daegu, South Korea, church chapel, and Haeju, North Korea, square.
That was the moment. That was the moment of horror. In the land of darkness without a glimpse of moonlight, suddenly there shone a bright light. Go, follow the light. Thunder roared and a path was revealed to me.
I betrayed my country and dreamed a treacherous life. Dream to find a better life for myself. Yes, I chose a traitor's life for rice and roses. But what roses? What roses? Cruel South Joseon didn't even let me touch a grain of rice. It fed me nothing but desperation, anxiety, shame, and mortification.
To the Republic of Korea will I go. I will get there in one day. I will testify why I chose this path and how my father risked his life for me.
Amen!
I was interrogated again and again by the puppets of South Korean Joseon regime. In that process, many defectors were butchered like dogs.
Our Heavenly Father saved me from the miserable pit of fire. He sustained my life throughout the perilous journey through the Tumen River, China, Mongolia, Thailand, and all the way to the Republic of Korea.
Friend, comrade, even a feast can fill your stomach if your heart is not pure. But if your heart is pure, even a gruel and straw shoe will content your heart.
If it were not for the love of Jesus, I wouldn't be standing here today.
Amen!
From today until the end of my days, I will follow Jesus and praise only his name.
Hallelujah!
This traitor of revolution who deserves nothing but being hung, drawn, and quartered has been embraced back into the loving arms of Republic again by our great leader. All hail our exalted commander-in-chief!
Children, Peaches, even when you're shitting, don't just sit on your ass. Study English words. I mean, how many times do I gotta tell you to read the newspapers? I ain't telling you to read fancy magazines, just read the goddamn papers. Your heads are full of shit, because all you're reading is Cosmo. If you're shitty at your job, you're not leaning in. Then your life is fucked. F-U-C-K-E-D, fucked! The girls at Venus are taking their clients out for gymnastics under the moonlight. They're blowing the fuck out of their minds with a full course. Handsy, footsy, central massage, girlfriend experience, blue dragon roller coaster, and shebang. What have you been doing? Peaches, the reviews say that we are serving boneless pork. From now on, you better not get kicked out during halftime. If you notice any cheap John who might not close his tab, hit up the manager. Viper Mama, Cho Deja ain't dead yet. 200 miles per hour, 70 times more toxic than a king cobra. When I spot prey, I eat it for my dinner. Player, manager, senior manager, madam, queen madam, mama, big mama. I am Cho Deja, who became the grandmama all on her own. You got it?
Seoul, North Korea, Hotesan Studio. Hotesan gobbles up a pizza. He has already finished a box of pizza by himself and has moved on to the second box. There's a pile of empty boxes of pizza and fried chicken and bottles of Coke. He gulps down a whole bottle of Coke.
Fucking swine. What's a finger licking?
Hotesan shoves a finger down his throat. He vomits.
You fucking rat. I'm hungry.
Hotesan eats a pizza again. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Munch, munch, munch. Seoul, South Korea, Office of Congressman.
You think this is a novel? Would you commission a painter to paint a painting without paint? Would you ask a chef to prepare a feast without fresh produce?
There's no need to be so emotional here. Just spice it.
Okay, give me some notes. notes or at least a voice recording.
The congressman doesn't have any time for that. I believe I've given you enough source material.
It's not enough. How am I supposed to ghostwrite an autobiography with that?
You're a novelist, right? Then write a novel.
Sorry?
It isn't easy to write something that didn't happen as if it happened. It isn't easy to write something that didn't take place as if it took place. Writing something that did happen, something that did take place, who doesn't know how to do that? You said you're a novelist, so write a novel.
You think an autobiography is a novel?
You're not getting any of this, are you?
Why are you smirking? What's so funny?
Was there enough to be smile about?
Why did you hire me? Because I wasn't asking for a blank check? Because I come cheap? Because I'm a fucking bargain? You think an autobiography is a novel? Sure, great. Okay, let's just say that it is a novel. You still can't have a novel. You know why? Because your characters don't want anything. Oh, a want. You know what a want is? You don't, do you? Because it's quite expensive. That check you gave me? Can't buy it. Check on Amazon if you can fucking order it for Prime shipping.
Chungcheon, North Korea, a schoolyard. Nam Kunsa is leading the North Korean middle school students.
Comrades, today we are going to master a highly technical collective move. Collectively circling forward with your hands on your comrade's waist. Can't do it. First, let me explain the significance of this move. This move symbolizes the satellites circling around the sun. Comrades, what does the sun represent? Yes, that's right. It is our father, our general. Therefore, you, student comrades, are baby satellites circling around our father, our general. All right, now watch and follow me. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Incheon, South Korea, elementary school classroom. Yook Sun Young is teaching her students English.
School bells ding ding dong.
Let's all gather.
Teacher's waiting in the class. Teacher's
waiting
in the class. Are you looking for something?
Yes, I am looking for my glasses.
Good job!
I'm looking for my orange.
So good!
Pass. 2 times 1 equals 2. 2, 9.
18.
3 times 1 equals 3. 3, 6.
18.
4 times 1 equals 4. 4, 7.
28.
Wow, fantastic.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
How I wonder what you are.
Up above the world.
Like a diamond in the sky. Yook Sun Young and her students march off as they sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Yoo Mo Nan falls behind the others and chases after them in confusion.
Wonju, South Korea, college classroom. Hotegang is standing at a podium.
Thus spoke Ingeborg Bachmann. To avoid separation, each of us should sense the schism. In a shared void, we should feel the same slash. We talk of the boundaries. Boundaries drawn by each and every word. Possessed by nostalgia, we will cross over the boundary and we'll create one harmony with all places. What does this mean? What do these words mean? You have no idea what this means, right? Neither do I. I'm not sure. That's it for class today. You know, I've heard rumors that the department is going to be shut down. But how would that even happen? I'll do what I can to prevent that, so don't worry too much. are you crying? Don't. Just don't. Look, okay, this isn't Alphonse Daudet's last story. This won't be the last lesson, okay? What kind of university fucking tosses out the Department of Philosophy? Can you even call that a university, a school, a country? Let's just go get drunk, okay? Come on, stop crying. Just stop.
So, auditorium. Youth Convention for the Union for Democratic Reunification. Zhou Mengnan plays her accordion.
This year, I will return to Pyongyang. No matter what, I will go. I'm not talking nonsense. I'm not being silly. I'm serious. Even if I have to walk, even if I have to swim across the Imjin River, I will go!
Somebody from north to Seoul. Huh? With 50 million, you can even go back to live in Pyongyang. Huh? You know Myeongjul, right? The country bumpkin from Pyongyang who used to come to our meeting? The guy who got wasted and sobered up only when he got a taste of my fist? That fool took 50 million and returned to Chosun. What the fuck in the world, crazy bastard?
Really?
Yes! He bundled up his money and crossed the Duman River once again.
And he didn't die?
Die? He became a hero for bringing all that money.
No, I can't believe you.
Woman, why can't you believe your husband's words? It's not just him. There are at least 100 people who went back. You bring them money, and you're forgiven. Crazy fuckers. Yeah, pour me another.
Is that true? Is it really possible to cross over to Joseph again? Is it true? Is it true? You shouldn't bluff.
Why would I bluff?
So is there really a way to go back to Joseph?
You want to go back? Why?
I want to live with my mother.
Yeah? Then you can rescue her out of North Korea. Is that all? Tell me the real reason.
I do not want to spend another day in this muck shithole.
Yeah? Well, tell me more.
Nobody's more patriotic than my mother. I want to live in my motherland with her.
Kim Jong-il slaps Jomong-nan.
Look, Pyongyang elite Jomong-nan, you trust me?
Can you send me back to Joseon?
You have the money?
How much will it take, sir? Will 50 million won do? How much will it cost? If only I can go back to Joseon, I will build a bridge to the heaven. Are you sure you're not bluffing?
You know what my name is? Hear my name clearly, once and for all. I am Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il? Look, at his ID. Look closer. Kim Jong-il. I am not a shoe factory worker, Kim Pyong-suk. I am no longer Kim Pyong-suk who had to live in the gutter. I am a citizen of the Republic of Korea, Kim Jong-il. You know why I changed my name so? Changing is one thing, but changing it to a name that makes you shudder in fear. The name of the great general is completely another. I changed it, yeah. But why change dick asshole's name that makes your limbs quake in your sleep? I put my life on the line. I am ready to die any day. All the brokers who claim to be the best have nothing on me. Why? Because I am Kim Jong-il. You want to go back to Joseon? Just bring me the money.
Jomong-nan pours a drink in his glass.
Yes, yes, pour it to the top. You know what they say? Put three blind comrades together and they can see the whole elephant. Take a shot and let's gather a collective wisdom. Real Joseon style. Raise your glass all together and rip it!
Hodesan Studio Apartment, Seoul, South Korea, January. Hodesan is laid down with his comforter over him. He has dressings on his wrist. Cho Deza talks to Chung Shin-hyun, who came for a house call.
So, when did he break up with her?
5 years ago.
Oh. He must have loved her very much. How long were they together?
How long? He was dumped after dating her for 100 days. Before they started dating, he followed her around for 10 years.
He doesn't have a job?
Doesn't look like he has one.
Okay, what about school? Does he have any degree?
PhD.
What? PhD?
What, you can't believe it?
In what?
Korean history. Why? It doesn't make any sense to you?
I think it would be best to hospitalize.
Why else would I bring you here? I thought a shrink trained in the U.S. might be different.
It's not like I have magic potion from the States. It's important that he wants to get better. You know, he wants to get better. Make sure he doesn't forget any prescriptions regularly.
I could see that myself.
Okay. He has a severe case of psychosomatic inordination. In other words, it's like psychosomatic disorders. Mm.
It would be an understatement to say that the chances of him committing suicide is well above the range.
What should I do?
Okay.
Please save my boy.
Okay, first he should take the prescription regularly.
Your first prescription! Determination, attention, affection, none of those cliches you tell all your patients. What is your professional opinion as a doctor? What's the fix? Is there anything experimental?
Okay, there's nothing like that. It's like...
Ah! Let him be loved!
Give me more.
Make the depressing. A positive prognosis depends on whether he can be moved to sing or not.
Sing?
So... play some good tunes. Okay, I gotta go. You know, it's crazy. I'm running late. It's time for me to head out.
You're playing expensive, huh?
She hands him an envelope with money.
Come to the salon sometime. I'll pick the cream. Yes, my baby.
Mom, when I was 7.
Yes? My baby.
You said we should just kill ourselves.
No.
Come on, you did.
No, I didn't.
Under the comforter?
No.
Son Ellen, would you like to die with your mom?
No.
Are you crying? It's okay. Life is supposed to be painful.
No, no.
Putigang studio apartment. Seoul, January. Putigang is hungover. Chayoung-mi is looking for something in the drawers.
You haven't deleted my number? Do you still act like that when you get drunk? Huh. You don't even remember, do you? Aren't you even curious?
About what?
She holds out his cell phone.
The reason why I have this.
Oh, I don't know. Give it back. Give it back to me.
Give me the cab fare. 9,401.
I don't have any cash. What do you want me to do?
Wire it to me.
Okay. Text me your account.
Chayoung-mi takes a brown photo album from the drawers.
What's that?
My old photos. I've always felt so uncomfortable about these.
Chayoung-mi takes her photos out of the album.
We kept a photo album?
We once thought we'd live happily ever after.
Hoteyang studio apartment. Seoul, South Korea, January. Hoteyang is naked under the comforter. Oh Young-hwan is wearing nothing except for his shorts. He drinks his coffee as he reads a magazine.
Can you hand me my clothes over there?
You're up.
Oh Young-hwan picks up the clothes strewn about the bed. Hoteyang dresses under the comforter.
What happened last night?
You don't remember?
No, it's a bit blurry. I was totally wasted.
Don't worry, I took precaution.
Did I? Fuck! In the end, this is how I get fucked.
Hey, watch your language.
Oh, ha ha ha. You pounded me once, yeah? But you don't own me, okay? Not a chance. How old are you now?
As old as a fourth grader. Times 5 plus 3.
You're ancient.
Well, somebody said the lines on my face are sexy. You remember that?
So, we were talking about the screenplay and, the war movie about the Vietnamese War, right? Then I blacked out.
Wait, you don't remember the Pinky Promise?
What was that for?
Forget about it.
Sorry, you're the one who has photographic memories, aren't you? Alright, so print them out and let me see. Are you really shooting this time?
Not yet. I'm working on my 7th draft.
So why are you writing about the Vietnamese War? It's all been done before. What's the plot?
A Korean soldier falls in love with a Viet Cong guerrilla in a battlefield.
Whoa, what a cliche! That's why the only thing on your IMDb page is your debut film.
You don't laugh. I'm this close to getting it produced. Hey, would you like...
You know I don't know a thing about the craft.
You're gonna do great. I bet you can structure a really tight plot. I can write dialogue fine, but structuring the plot isn't my forte. You said you're sick and tired of being a cheap, obscure writer. You said you were disillusioned about the whole thing.
You're a poor fucker, you know that? You've got no car, no money, no wife. You have only one thing in plenty. Your age. So why are you following me around?
Because I love you.
Liar. Hey, Mr. Sexy Wrinkles. Get over here.
Chotitsa's room salon. Seoul, February. On a sofa, Kangguk-sik is lying on his stomach. Chotitsa hops on Kangguk-sik's back and massages him, giving it her heart and soul.
How does it feel, sir?
It feels like I'm back in Korea.
How long are you staying this time?
3 months.
Oh, 3 months? What's keeping you for so long this time, sir?
English time.
Wouldn't that be too risky?
Oh, 처음엔 또 봐. 된도 살까?
Oh, 마이네, 마이네.
You should play a part too.
Me, sir? How dare I?
Money management. Recruiting the ants.
Yes, sir.
If things go well, you'll get an aquarium.
Thank you, sir.
How is your business? Is there any problem? Okay, Goldie.
Yeah,
money? Sponsors? I got you back. Why are you crying?
I have no one but you, Mr. Chairman.
You know I can't deal with sentimentality.
Oh, God, I apologize.
Your Japanese has improved a lot, by the way.
Domo arigato gozaimashita.
Health is the most important thing in life. I haven't gone peach picking in a while.
Oh, yes, sir. Nomine!
Mire, meaning future, right?
Nomine walks in, takes Gangguk Sik by his arm, and heads out with him.
Yuri, send in the new recruit.
Chomong Nan walks in with an accordion.
Name. It is Chomong Nan.
Mong Nan. Wild Magnolia. Hmm? Is the name fitting for our courtesan? Where in Yanbian, China, are you from?
I'm from Pyongyang, ma'am. I heard that there is an opening for a pianist. I saw the advertisement. Have I found the right place?
To make 5 million won a month by playing the piano.
Is this a house of adult entertainers? I understand. I will leave presently.
Ooh. Are you any good with it? The accordion?
It's no matter now. I will see myself out immediately.
Spring. Hote-san's studio apartment. Seoul, March. Hote-san is sleeping with his comforter over him. Chotita pours rice wine in a bowl all the way to the top and drinks it up. There are bottles lying around on the floor. Hote-gang and Hote-yan enter.
You're here! Oh, sweet babies! My babies!
Chotita hugs them and kisses them on their cheeks.
You stink!
Sun's not down and you're drinking already.
I've never seen you two come together. Look how lovely it is to see you two together.
We just met around the corner.
Hey, Mom, you gotta think of your health. Think of your age.
It's all right, it's all right. It's been a while. I just had one drink.
Here, take one.
Both of you.
Out of all my mom's different personas, I get to see the drunkard the most often. She's got swag.
You're sarcastic, huh, fucking educator? College professors are the top.
No worries, though. The world is changing and our bunch might go extinct soon.
Why? You don't tell me you got drunk and got yourself in trouble. Did you screw a girl in your class?
Okay, you call this at the crack of dawn for drunken shenanigans?
I had to butter him up again and again to make him take the pills and get some sleep. Don't you pity him?
That's the routine. So what's new?
Yeah. What did I tell you? is your eldest brother's name?
Here we go.
You want me to take the hammer out? Huh? Come on, tell me.
Hate-san, the mountain.
And what is your elder brother's name?
Hate-gang, the river.
And you?
Hate-yang, the sun.
That's right. Hate-yang. There's a mountain, there's a river, but no matter how high the mountain is, no matter how deep the river runs, they are nothing without Taeyang, the sun. You know what I mean? You are the light and the warmth for your brothers. Got it? You have to cuddle these poor man babies. Got it?
Chodita suddenly slaps Hate-gang.
Ow!
How did I raise you?
Fuck!
Say it!
Hate-gang pours rice wine down his throat.
Selling booze. Are you satisfied?
And?
That's enough.
I hoard myself out!
She takes out a hammer and puts it down on the floor.
What's this hammer? This is the one thing that your father left when he died at the age of 26, working shitty manual labor. It is the last thing your father left when he went thousands of miles away to Saudi Arabia so that he could work himself to death, literally. Nothing. Just with the money from your father's life insurance, which wasn't worth shit. For what? Huh? To raise my babies! My babies! You! Hate-gang, is this all you can do for your brother? You didn't visit him until it got this bad for him? The hammer shudders with anger, you motherfucker! If Tae-san dies like that, we're all gonna die together. We're gonna smash our heads with the hammer and die. Got it?
She holds Tae-young's hand.
Don't cry, my baby. You two should look after him. Come by, talk to him, sing together, yeah? The doctor said that he needs love. You hear that? Love, true love. Look at his face. It's rotten. Completely rotten. What's wrong?
It hurts.
Where? Your chest.
Inside. My insides are breaking apart.
He must have dreamt again.
Dream? What dream?
Dream of that woman. What else?
God, it's unbearable to watch him. You crazy fucker. Get it together, you fucking loser. Stop all this for God's sake.
Ow!
Fuck! What did I do? Mom, you're spoiling him. Look at this, look at us, look at our life. You don't like this and you don't like that, huh? If you don't want to live, let's just end everything. What the fuck are we waiting for?
Chodita picks up the hammer.
All right, let's die here. Now!
Stop! Hate-gang steals the hammer.
I'll die, let's die!
Hate-gang smashes his own head with the hammer.
Do we know you?
My contract begins today. How do you do, ma'am?
Hate-gang studio apartment, Seoul, April. Hate-gang is drinking with his students.
Professor Ho, I really wasn't gonna say this.
You're drunk.
You can do that. I heard you got a job at another university. Everybody knows.
Just drink.
What are you, huh? You fucking coward.
Hey, shut up and drink.
Don't live like that.
Why are you studying philosophy? Tell me. Wondu-san, you, why are you so silent? You want me to spell it out for you? It's because that is the only department your grades allowed you to apply for. You wanted to get into a reputable college, but you couldn't choose a popular department. No? You gonna say I got it wrong?
That's not true. You can't say that.
Not true, I can't say that. Why? You're happy, aren't you? It's so hard to get transferred to another department, and the university administration says that you could choose whichever department you want. Wonderful, isn't it? It's so much better than graduating with a degree in philosophy that gets you nowhere. It just can't get any better. What serendipity, no? Don't indulge yourself by playing a martyr.
Professor Huh, I'm really disappointed in you. Come on, let's go. Get up. Oh, you're not coming? Come on, let's go.
Sit down. I'm not finished. You're a philosopher? You ain't no philosopher.
Oh.
You're just an impostor.
So, can you philosophize? Hey, you philosophy major from a shithole college, Immanuel Kant, the shit out of this drink.
She burned!
Stop! Patigan gives Sahindar a hug.
Don't cry. Just have another drink.
Patigan studio apartment. Seoul, April. Oh Young Hwan is pacing.
Okay, let's go over it one more time. Platoon commander Cha Ming-hyung, who was ambushed during a search mission, is left all alone in the jungle. When he opens his eyes, Su-an taking care of him. When the village is about to be mercilessly attacked by the U.S. Army, Cha Ming-hyung prevents it. Through this incident, Min-hyuk and Su-an fall in love. Even after Min-hyuk returns to his platoon, the romance continues. But it turns out Su-an is a secret Viet Cong agent. Cha Ming-hyuk's platoon is ambushed by the villagers, who turn out to be guerrillas. Even in the midst of this, Min-hyuk tries to save Su-an, but Su-an heartlessly pulls the trigger and Min-hyuk. Su-an is then shot to death by the Korean soldiers. It isn't too bad. It's all right, right?
It's all right. Yeah. But it doesn't have that final punch. You know, didn't you say that the producer said the same thing?
What can we do? So, let's say I'm Cha Ming-hyuk and you are Su-an. Did you even love me? Or is it that you love me, but your patriotism made you pull the trigger? Or did you take an advantage of me pretending as if you loved me? How do I make this convincing?
You know, sometimes you can't figure out your own feelings. She won Min-hyuk's heart to manipulate him, but as time goes by, she starts having feelings for him too. Maybe she kills Min-hyuk because she wants to rein in her feelings for him. But at the last moment, Min-hyuk doesn't shoot her, even though he can. She looks into his eyes and she realizes, oh, in love with this man.
So she takes Min-hyuk's hands and disappears into a secret forest, a jungle where elephants roam around, as you said? That's ridiculous!
Well, we can still think about the ending.
Oh, man. In war films, everybody dies! That's the formula! You gotta die!
Got it. No, got it all worked up. But it's definitely a cliche. No offense, but I feel like I've heard this story before.
What did you just say? Man, what do I know about films?
What if we change the genre, huh? Well, what about an action or thriller?
I've spent years doing research, investigating, and interviewing.
I can write a fabulous melodrama, a mystery melodrama.
Leave me alone. I need some space.
This is my place. This is my room. Where are you going? All right. Pote-san Studio, Seoul, April. Pote-san is sleeping under his comforter. Cho Mong-nan plays The Labyrinth of Love by Choi Jin-hee on her guitar.
Wandering where the morning begins. Who the glorious light igniting my spirit.
singer. Did I scare you? What?
Did you just wake up, sir? You surprised me.
Why?
It's been 15 days.
What?
You haven't said a word, sir.
Yeah? I didn't talk for that long. Sing it again.
Pardon?
That song you were singing, sing it again.
Wondering where the mountain bed.
Now you know, you should never mess around with music.
Pardon?
You got the lyrics all wrong. You've turned the greatest hit into the greatest shit. I mean, do you even know what the title of the song is?
Mountain back to where the sun rises.
It's Labyrinth of Love. Labyrinth of Love. Look, repeat after me. No matter how much I try.
No matter how much I try.
I just can't grasp love.
I just can't grasp love.
My heart blinded by love.
My heart blinded by love.
Cries because of the truth. Look, never mind. Just write it down.
Zhou Mengnan writes down the lyrics on a piece of paper.
In a corner of your heart, I plant all my love for you. Please don't ever hurt me. Never, ever, with no end or beginning, infinite, oh, the labyrinth of love. Done? Sing it like that from now on. And don't make a love song political. Where's the fun in that?
You must love this song very much, sir.
Of course. It was Yang Mei's favorite.
Sir, I know you're not just acting out. You must have loved her very much. It must have been a sorrowful parting. How long has it been since the last time you saw her? Nothing makes your heart ache more than longing for someone you can't see. It's been 1 year for me, but it feels like it's been 10 years. Day can feel longer when you're young for someone. Your heart feels like it's been tripped by a stone again and again. You feel like you're sinking under the ground deeper and deeper.
Hey.
I understand. Please forgive me for rambling, sir.
No, you know that feeling? That feeling that your heart is being tripped again and again? Your heart's sinking underground. Deeper and deeper. You know that.
Even when you're still, your heart throbs. And your breath is stopped. You walk and walk, but you circle around the man in the field of rubbles. Even if you lie down to sleep, you feel like you're standing all by yourself in an empty lawn. And then all of a sudden, all the way down the cliff, you feel like you're falling.
Yeah. Have you ever been on a pirate ship ride?
What's that?
What about the Blue Dragon roller coaster? You guys don't even have a theme park. You don't know roller coasters.
Are you talking about guns and cereal cars?
What cars?
Do you mean the one that falls from high place, like this?
Yes!
You can ride it, I guess, and you park, sir.
Do you have...
Are you talking about the swing boat? We have that too. I've tried it once.
Yeah. How does it feel?
It was fun, but it felt so weird. It felt like my body was falling.
Yes. And that fall, the fall that feels like it's endless without a bottom. I mean, what do you think? Doesn't that feel similar to that feeling that your heart is sinking under the ground? Like
that sounds right. When you think of it, it does feel like when you're on the same boat.
I'm glad we're on the same boat. I mean, you know that feeling too. Breathing is like a surge. Living is like being on a pirate ship.
Even when I lie down to go to sleep, I can't. I just wrestle with the night. What's the matter?
Coming again.
Ah! Are you feeling okay, sir?
coal light bulbs in Joseon, in North Korea? We call the light bulbs in the balls. And do you know what we call tubular bulbs? Tubular bulbs are long balls. Chandelier is a kind of balls. Candle bulbs are peanut balls. Isn't it funny?
Putti-san hands her a packet of gum.
Open it.
Jomong-nan unwraps the gum and hands it to Putti-san.
In my mouth.
Jomong-nan puts the gum down in front of Putti-san.
What? Are you kidding me?
I refuse to do
this. You didn't pay to do this. Shouldn't you do what you're paid to do?
Putti-san takes his pants off.
Suck it.
You will like me to soak your pants in detergent?
Jomong-nan picks up the pants.
Never mind. Here. Give it back to me.
Putti-san retrieves the pants and puts it back on as he chews the gum.
I can't seem to understand your meaning, sir. Thank you, sir.
For what?
Madam Jo said that I will get paid ₩1,000,000 every time you left. What do you call it? Bonus?
I'll put in a good word for you, but you're really funny.
Aren't you glad that I am? How can you feel so tired after so much sleep?
I wish I could sleep properly for once, deep and sound.
Putti-san takes the pills, puts the pill box near his head, and lies down.
Are you gonna sleep?
I will, soon.
Jomong-nan heads to her sleeping spot away from Putti-san's. She takes her pills and lies down.
You wanna sleep next to me? Please? I don't know, we'll just cuddle.
I have a third degree black belt in Taekwondo. You have been warned, sir.
Look, I really can't sleep. Please.
Jomong-nan sits by him.
Stop whining. This will make it easier for you to fall asleep. Hanjeon belly, legs straight, eyes shut, lips close them to your mind. And tell yourself everything is fine. Everything is fine.
Jomong-nan returns to her place and lies down. She sits up and she looks at the piece of paper.
No matter how much I try, I just can't rest love, my heart blinded by love, cries because of the truth.
Bae Myung-hee's sublease department, Seoul, May.
So, you are getting paid $3 million per month? Let's see. Then you gotta save every penny for at least a year and a half to make $50 million.
On a condition that I'll get paid in a lump sum at the end of the year, I will be paid $50
million. Yeah? Can you rely on them?
They're not the kind of people who fool around with money.
Oh, you have hit the jackpot.
About the thing that you promised me to look into, how's that going?
Are you determined to do it?
Yes.
On your life?
Yes, I am.
Right. This Kim Jong-hyo found a fail-cell safe route.
Are you absolutely sure about it?
One person each in Incheon, Shenyang. It's quite a project. It's thrice harder than taking somebody out of North Korea. You should never think that $50 million is too much.
I understand.
So you'll be prepared with the money before the end of the year? Everything else will be taken care of by then. So don't worry about anything other than the money. I'll let you eat the New Year's rice cake soup in the Democratic People's Republic of Korea.
You are so fortunate. Things are working out so smoothly.
Everything should be fine. If you want to take a carriage to the wedding, if you want things to go smooth, watch your mouth.
Anyway, why isn't it not here yet? No one expects a voyage with an empty stomach to appreciate the majesty of Mountain Kyungan. Oh! Turn it on now. It's time for the lottery.
Oh, right.
Bim Yong-hee turns the TV on. Ding dong. Kim Jong-il opens the door. Chun Won-sung comes in with a pizza.
What took you so long?
I'm sorry. It's 15,900 won.
Kim Jong-il takes the pizza and hands him the money.
Excuse me. I said it's 15,900 won.
I know.
You still need to pay 900 won.
You know how many minutes you're late?
I'm sorry. I got lost.
You got lost.
Yeah. I'm new to this job. I'm sorry.
Listen to me. That 15,901 includes a price for the promise that you will deliver it on time. You are 15 minutes late. So should I pay you the 9?
I sincerely apologize, sir.
Yeah, well, where's your work ethic, huh?
I apologize, please.
Kim Jong-il hands him 1,000 won.
Work hard, got it? Keep the change.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You may leave. Barbarian. He was lucky I was in a mood for mercy.
It's starting.
Oh, yeah?
Kim Jong-il and Bae Yoon-hee hold the lottery ticket and watch the TV.
8. Yes, I got it.
15. Oh, why can't I get one right?
6. No.
25.
7. Let's see.
17. Why can't these numbers be in unison? They're all daunting. Huh, they're all communally fucking me.
Summer and autumn. Putty sets up studio apartment. Seoul, July. Putty Young is watching platoon. Jomung-nan is teaching Putty-san how to play accordion.
Pay attention to the bean sprouts. See how the bean sprouts are divided into different sections? Be the colors of the bean sprouts.
I can't do it.
One can't achieve anything at the first step, sir. Okay, let's try again.
Yo, North Korean.
Yes, ma'am.
Come over here for a sec.
Putty-young makes Jomung-nan sit right next to her. Putty-san practices accordion by himself.
So,
North Korean.
Yes, ma'am. I'm just really curious. The TV presenter in the North Korean news, you know? The older woman who is always in the traditional hanbok. The new one? What's wrong with her? That lady has got to do something about her hair. Is hair style like hereditary too? What the heck is wrong with you guys, huh?
When something's done, things rarely change, ma'am.
Yeah, dictatorship must be in your nature. It must be. You know, air can't come in unless there's a hole for it to get out. And your country seriously needs some ventilation. You need fresh air. What did you do on the day when Kim Jong-il died?
You cried in a corner, didn't you?
Say something. North Korean, you cried when Kim Il-sung died, didn't you?
I don't remember that well, ma'am.
Liar. You sobbed right in front of the statue of Kim Il-sung. You boo-hooed, oh, my dearest leader. I can tell you're lying.
Have you seen the statue?
Of course. On TV, it disgusts me. It is so tacky. I mean, a statue slathered with gold?
If you behold it, you will be moved, and tears will well up. You shouldn't judge until you see for yourself, ma'am.
What?
How can human hands create something like that? Is it really possible to create something like that with human hands? It is truly moving, ma'am.
You are so naive. It's not that you can't make it, you just don't make it.
When I first came to Seoul, the statue of General Lee Sun-sin startled me. There it was at the center of the city, like a dwarf, black, frowning. I thought it was Jap.
North Korea that much, just go back. Just cross the border again.
Why did you run away?
I did not run away, ma'am.
Then what? What? Why can't you speak? You got into trouble, didn't you? You're quite ready. Did you hit on a married man? You know, somebody high up in the Labor Party, yeah? You're frowning. Oh, you look scary. You're gonna light a sea of flames, huh? What, you're gonna start a military provocation? I like it. I really like it. I like you. You're not too bad, you know? My mom likes you. Are you gonna marry my brother?
No, ma'am.
How long are you staying then?
I'll be here just until the winter comes.
Until the winter? If you're gonna leave, just leave. Don't go breaking his heart. You slept with him, didn't you?
No, I did not.
Oh, you totally did, didn't you?
Why do you treat people like that? You should not taunt others, ma'am. Why do you speak of such nonsense? Please don't blow the Prussian trumpet.
What's going on?
Okay, I'm sorry. Please don't pull the bullshit trumpet!
I like you.
Come over here.
Bo Taeyang makes Cho Meng Nan sit more comfortable.
Let's just chill and watch this together, huh? Let it go, North Korean. You've never seen this film, have you? It's an American film titled Platoon. It's a pretty decent war film. Watch American films in the North?
Why not? We have everything except for the things we don't have now.
I heard that you guys can even watch Korean TV shows.
In North Korea, all American films have the same title.
Yeah? What are they called?
Fucking bastards. Isn't that Vietnam?
Vietnam? Yes, Vietnam! Vietnam! You know the Vietnamese War?
Why wouldn't I know, ma'am?
Oh, right. I guess you guys also took a course on world history or something.
My grandmother was a Vietnam War hero.
Right. Wait, hold on. That doesn't make any sense.
What do you mean, ma'am?
Your grandmother is Vietnamese?
No, she's not, ma'am.
Then how? How can a North Korean woman be a hero of the Vietnamese War?
Because she was. She was a war hero, ma'am. What's so strange about it?
Really? Did the North Koreans participate in the Vietnamese War? I don't think you guys did.
I merely told you what I've been told, ma'am. I've heard the story many times since I was a child. I haven't seen my grandmother's medallions, too.
Bo Taeyang looks it up on her phone.
Oh, wow. It's for real. North Korean government admitted that they have dispatched platoons to Vietnam only when memorials were found in the country.
Bo Taeyang walks in through the door with a book.
Oh, look at you, looking cozy.
Hey.
Yep, this looks like home. You're the one who invited me and you don't even say hello?
Okay, hold on, I'm in the middle of something.
Oh, look at this novelist who can't even take her hands off of a smartphone.
I don't write novels anymore.
Look at that handsome face, huh? Looking good, looking good. How have you been?
Sir. Cho Meng-nan goes to Ho Tae-san and helps him with the accordion.
You really came. You don't have lectures today?
Nope. I've got nothing for a while.
Why?
You don't want to know. All right, what happened? Why did you summon me?
If we don't take care of him, Mom's going to cut off our monthly allowances.
I knew it. You'd never do anything for free. Is he catching up fine?
He's good. He's been working hard, sir.
That's great. Really. Thank you.
It is my pleasure, sir.
Bo Taeyang gives Ho Tae-san a book.
If you get bored, read this. The title is filthy, but it's a fun read.
All right, thanks.
You know a bit about history, don't you?
The history of shit and piss.
Mm-hmm. It's much better than Korean history. I mean, how do you call that history? It's so pathetic.
Even the title stinks so much. I wouldn't even use that thing as a coaster.
Oh, you think you're so much better than that? It was published by the publisher that boycotted your novel.
Oh, fuck. I told you I'm done with novels.
Why? You're Remember the pretty girl in your university, one of the younger ones? She's become a big shot. She came on TV the other day.
Oh, that is ridiculous. You know how her novel got so popular? There was a TV show with Wonbin, you know, the hottest male actor, and her book was on his desk. It's ludicrous.
Somebody's jealous.
Okay, don't.
Taeyang, history is dying. Literature is dying. And philosophy is dying. We can't let this happen. I will philosophize until the end of my days, and you should do the same with your novels. I know things are difficult, but we should be the watchers of the age.
Words, pretty words. You are such a cliché. Stop. But you are the phoniest hypocrite. Sometimes people fool themselves, but when it becomes a habit, you get fooled by yourself. And you're kind of like that. You're on the brink of fooling yourself. The way I see it, there's no one more conservative than you. You are no progressive.
Hoteon takes a call.
Yeah, right. Did you take a look at it? Yes, I said yes. They did send the platoons. Yes. I know, right?
Hote-san succeeds in playing a section with the accordion.
You've done it! As I have promised, here is your reward, sir.
Jomongnan picks up her guitar.
Nice to hear the sound of a guitar. It's been a while. You know, maybe I should take guitar lessons.
Yeah, I thought you were pretty decent.
No. I tried and I could not play C. I gave up.
Did you? Mongnan, can we talk for a sec?
Hoteyang makes Jo Mongnan sit next to her.
So, your grandmother fought in the Vietnamese... No, the Wenlam. Yes? Your grandmother fought in the Wenlam War?
Yes, ma'am.
Hoteyang's studio apartment. So, toast with beer cans.
Let's go over it once more.
Okay, platoon leader Cha Min-hyuk is ambushed during a search mission and is left alone in the jungle.
When he opens his eyes, he is at a peaceful village in a forest and finds a Vietnamese maiden, Suan, treating him.
Suddenly, the village is about to be mercilessly attacked by the American troops, but Cha Min-hyuk and Suan save the day.
Through this incident, Min-hyuk and Suan fall in love. But!
But! Suan, who Min-hyuk believed to be Vietnamese, turns out to be Yeo Muk-nan, a North Korean soldier.
Hold on. I wanted to bring this up for a while, but don't you think the name is a bit weird? Muk-nan?
Why? I'm feeling it. You know, Mongnan, wild magnolia is North Korea's national flower, you know? It's symbolistic.
Really? Yeah, that makes sense. Learns that Suan is not Vietnamese, but Yeo Mongnan, North Korean woman.
Min-hyuk conceals the fact and returns to the platoon. Soon, American troops request a mission.
Obliterate the village.
And Min-hyuk volunteers as an advance guard to inform Muk-nan and rushes to the village.
But under Muk-nan's leadership, the guerrillas in the village have already commenced an attack.
In the middle of a Vietnamese jungle.
Cha Min-hyuk, a South Korean man, and
Ryo Muk-nan, a North Korean woman.
Point a gun at each other. Oh, who will pull the trigger first?
Or can these star-crossed lovers overcome their fate with love?
Oh, ideology or love?
Oh, war or bloodline?
Hoteyang studio apartment, Seoul, September. Hoteyang and Cho Tae-sa sit across from each other. The hammer is
All right, huh?
What do you want me to do? The whole department has been shut down.
So how are you gonna pay the bills?
I'm leaving this country.
You son of... Leave! Where to?
She raises the hammer.
All right, go to Saudi Arabia like your father and fucking die there.
I am not my father!
You're not going out of this country! It is not happening! Got it?
Okay, I'll just take some time off and think. Recharge.
Snap out of it! If you take some time off, you'll be off forever! You wanna sit on your ass when you gotta do everything you can to catch up with the guys running ahead of you? The guys running behind you will kick your ass and step all over you! Have you ever seen a marathoner who fell down, rose back up, and won a gold medal? Huh? Recharge. Set that up so that people behind them will slack off.
She holds Taegon's hand.
Gon, having a son who is a professor, that's the silver lining in my life. That's my pride.
Right, I see.
Professor Kim dropped by. I heard that there will be a job opening at the end of the year. Go get it. $50 million and all that. It's not bad.
Why did he say that?
The university isn't in Seoul, but I heard that it's more prestigious than the university you taught at, with a rich history.
Stop it.
Listen to me.
Seriously, I don't want to do it. I can find something else on my own.
Just do. Paint your house. And you're all dressed up. You're going somewhere?
No. Just for a change.
Strike the iron while it's hot. Stay there, no matter what. All right?
I'll do what I can. So okay, no more intervention, please. What about you, Mom? You look pale. Rough days.
When was it not rough?
Why, Mr. America isn't helping you out these days?
He's in a crisis too. Ashita wa naozu desu. Tomorrow is a mystery.
Really?
Only those who survive the inciting incident and exposition get to experience the crisis. Should you wish to stay alive as a protagonist through the climax until the end, you have to spin the crisis into an opportunity.
Okay. Happy ending is not the only sort of ending.
Don't you
care of yourself. I heard that Tae-san is getting better.
Yes. I can finally breathe.
That North Korean maiden. She's gonna be my sister-in-law one day, huh?
Young, healthy, wholesome, with common sense. It's hard to find a girl like that these days. Why, you wanna have a taste?
Mom!
I'm heading out.
Cho Tae-sak starts to leave, but returns and embraces Cho Tae-gon.
Did you really come out of my womb? I'm some baby.
They leave. Cho Tae-gon returns and looks at the clock. Looking in the mirror, he grooms himself. He takes a bottle of wine and glasses from a bookshelf and places them on a table. He plays classical music on a record player. Ding dong! Cho Tae-gon opens the door. Cho Mung-nan walks in. She has put on makeup and is wearing a skirt.
Hi. Wow, you look breathtaking in purple. Oh, please, take a seat. Whew, it's September and it's still hot.
Did you practice, sir? Cho Tae-gon opens the wine bottle with no trouble. He pours the wine into the glasses.
If you haven't practiced, I'm never coming back.
I heard you like wine. We should celebrate. It's been 1 month since you started teaching me.
Yes, it's been a month and you still can't play chords, sir. What is your guitar?
You're making me nervous. Let's just finish this glass.
Cho Tae-gon raises his glass to propose a toast. Cho Mung-nan raises her glass too. Clink. Cho Tae-gon gulps down the whole glass. Cho Mung-nan doesn't drink a drop. Cho Tae-gon brings his guitar. He plays basic chords. There's nothing right about the melody or rhythm.
Have you really practiced, son?
Yes, of course.
Those marvelous fingers are wasted on you.
Cho Mung-nan takes the guitar and demonstrates.
Do it like this. All right? Try again.
Cho Tae-gon holds the guitar.
No, I told you not to hold it.
like that.
Zhou Mengnan corrects him. There.
Would you sing a song for me?
No.
He turns off the violin player.
If you'd sing me a song, I'd get inspired. If you sing me a song, my hidden talent might start to shine.
What am I supposed to do with you, sir?
Zhou Mengnan picks up the guitar.
Mother wants to send me off with a man, but how should I tell her what's in my heart? I like a comrade working at the gold mine, not the city lay. But I can't tell yet. Oh, I can't tell. I can't tell.
Zhou Mengnan hands over the guitar.
Do you really prefer a country bumpkin over a city lad?
Now let's practice.
I mean, what's your type? Are you seeing someone? I feel like you have a secret boyfriend.
Please?
Okay, all right, I'll stop.
Ko Thi Gong plays the guitar. It sounds funny. He suddenly holds the guitar like a professional musician.
Tame your heart and sing an invigorating song. Why did you lie, sir? You're such a wonderful musician, and why did you lie all this time? How could you do that to me?
You know why.
Ko Thi Gong pulls Zhou Mengnan in and kisses her. Zhou Mengnan struggles to get away from him. Studio apartment, Seoul, October. Ko Thi-san and Zhou Mengnan are sitting with a big box in between them.
You can't open it, sir?
Ko Thi-san sits with his back against the box.
Would you like me to put it back in?
Just throw it away.
No. If you made up your mind, open it with your own hands, sir.
Zhou Mengnan holds his hand. She leads his hand to the box so that he can open it. Ko Thi-san opens the box.
Great job.
There are various things inside the box, including gifts and letters.
What are these? Why are you keeping empty cans?
We drank from them. The first time we had a date by the Han River.
What in the world? We didn't throw them away. And what are these?
She gave me some kimchi in those Tupperwares.
Doesn't she even know that you've kept all these?
Zhou Mengnan takes shopping bag handles that are cut from the shopping bags.
What are these?
The shopping bags she gave me.
And where are the shopping bags?
Well, Yang Yang was holding them in her hands. I just couldn't throw it away.
What in the world? Come on.
Oh, can we stop, please? It feels like my guts are being ripped away from me.
How will you throw them all away if you're not going to lose them?
Zhou Mengnan brings in a garbage bag.
Are you going to throw them away? Good riddance.
Chorita walks through the front door.
Great job, my son! Bravo, my son! Well done, play some music!
Zhou Mengnan plays the accordion.
Oh my god, oh, that's disturbing.
You're laughing!
Chorita holds Ko-Thi-san and they dance together. Ko-Thi-san walks through the front door. Chorita tries to kiss Ko-Thi-san on his lips. He gets away from her.
Hey, what are you doing? It's embarrassing.
Ko-Thi-san takes the garbage bag out.
You came to see your brother. Good girl.
No, I came to see our Mengnan. Mengnan, could you do me a little favor?
Ko Thi-san takes a script out of her
You underestimated me, didn't you? You underestimated me, didn't you?
Comrade, you gave me a cursory glance, didn't you?
Right, you're right, great. Okay, what about I regret the day I met you?
Meeting you, comrade, was an error.
Great.
Is this the film literature you're talking about?
Yes.
What is it about?
It's a war movie.
Did you use the story about my grandmother?
Why?
Nothing. How much are you getting paid to write this?
How much? $50 million.
$50 million won?
It's nothing. You can't call yourself a successful writer unless you write a hit play that pays you at least $100 million. So how should I say, my fist is shuddering and bellowing? How can I make that sound more aggressive?
My fist is your burning flame.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Right. Okay. What about my fist is crying that I should beat you down?
My fist commands me to knock you.
Mom, see you later. My deadline is coming up real soon.
Hu Tianyang rushes out. Sits Cho Mengran down.
How does he sleep these days?
He still needs his pills.
He needs to get off the pills. You're the only one who can do it.
I'll make it happen by the end of the year, ma'am.
By the end of the year? Why, are you going somewhere next year?
I beg your pardon?
You look into my eyes, look. Are you seeing someone?
Pardon? No, I'm not.
Then where are you going?
I just have somewhere to go.
I will ask you just one more time. Are you seeing someone or not?
No, I'm not.
Are you sure? I will take your word. I'll make a proposal. Make your decision swiftly, but with consideration. Do you want to live with Tae-san for the rest of your life, or do you want to pack up and leave today?
Out of the blue.
This can't go on. Tae-san shouldn't develop feelings for you anymore. If you two are going to bond, be committed. If you can't commit yourself to him, get out. Right now. Tough, right? Some call this a crisis of a lifetime, and others call it a chance that you will never get again in your life. Do you want this to be a crisis, or do you want to grab this chance and put a silver spoon in your mouth? Pack!
I'll stay.
If you're gonna have a second thought, you take it back now. It's not too late.
No, no. I'll stay.
I'm glad you made the choice. Thank you. Thank you, Mengnan. Let's set the wedding date to sometime in spring at the Shila Hotel. Let's book the biggest hall there, the grand ballroom.
Madame Jo.
Yeah, madam! Call me mom! Julia, mom! Come on!
Mom.
That's right!
Mom, I hope you will still pay me the salary in December.
A 50 million? Sure! What do you plan to do with that?
I really need to send the money somewhere.
Where?
To the north. My family.
All right. I won't ask the details. 50 million, that's your problem. That's nothing.
She strokes Mongnan's hands.
Mongnan, our son is old, short, and ugly. I'm
As you know,
he has a heart of gold. His eyes won't stray away from you. Once he falls in love, that's it.
I know.
So, what do you have to do now? Make a baby!
Cho Tae-za takes the hammer out.
This hammer is the keepsake left by your grandfather-in-law. During the Japanese occupation. With this hammer,
Cho Man-woo built the safe house for our founding father, Kim-gu. With this hammer, he smashed the head of the fucking Japanese colonizers. This hammer was then handed down to his son, Ho Pung-guru. And then I have been keeping it. This historical hammer, which traveled from Manchuria to Saudi Arabia, is yours now. Mongnan, take this hammer.
Why? Why are you giving this to me?
Mongnan, use this hammer only for family.
Cho Mongnan takes the hammer. Hodigang Studio Apartment, Seoul, November. Cho Tita has a baseball cap and sunglasses on. She holds a wine glass, looking out the window. Hodigang pours wine in her glass.
You like her that much?
That girl has a sound mind.
Mom?
What?
What about me?
You what?
Do you think she'd have been a good match for me?
Are you fucking crazy? You can do so much better than that. Are you?
I was just joking. I was just joking. What's happening today, by the way? Something's up. You haven't taken your hammer out. Taeyong said something's funny with you.
You got a cigarette.
Ho Taegang lights up a cigarette and hands it to Jo Tae-ja.
I've been fucked.
By who? Mr. America?
Cho Tae-ja puffs the smoke out.
How bad is it?
Air raid siren bad.
It's got to do with that English town or something?
He stole from the ant sideways and dove into the Pacific Ocean. He stole from me too, I've been cleaned out.
Shit, son of a bitch, we should find him!
I might get arrested. I'm gonna be a wanted woman very soon.
Are you serious? How did you let things come to this?
I'm gonna lie low. Out of reach. We should go separate ways, look out for ourselves. Taesun's gonna be fine with Mongnan, so please take good care of Taeyang.
Cho Tae-ja puts out the cigarette, takes an envelope out, and gives it to Ho Taegang.
What's this?
50 million.
Forget about it. We have bigger fish to fry.
I scripted, saved everything I have left. Take it.
Oh, come on, Mom.
I am going to the safe house, so let me have peace of mind.
Ho Taegang receives the envelope.
How long do you think it will take?
I don't know. Spring will come.
Ho Taegang holds Cho Tae-ja's hands.
Mom, when this is over, let's live a new life. Not like this. A different life, please.
Black Mama won't be finished that easy. You know who I am.
Winter. Ho Tae-san Studio Apartment, Seoul, December. Ho Tae-san practices accordion on his own. Cho Mongnan is sitting, leaning against the wall.
Where have you been?
Too loud, Mr. Ho.
Ho Tae-san stops playing. Cho Mongnan approaches Ho Tae-san.
I've been to the salon. It looked like it's been closed for a while. What's happening?
I'm not so sure.
Please don't lie. What's the matter?
No, I've already told you. I'm so sorry. But there's nothing we can do other than wait. Just take it easy. Things will get better.
Could you just tell me what's happening? She's not showing up here. She's not picking up the phone. And creditors are coming here to demand their money back. So what's happening? Is she on the run? Why? Is it because she's out of money? Is that what's happening, Mr. Ho?
Probably.
Don't be so ambiguous. I'm drowning, and you're flaunting your strokes, having fun? When is she coming? Is she coming back this year? You said that you should give her just one more day, and it's been 15 days. When is she coming? I can't just say anything.
I don't know. Let's stop all of this.
Then what about my money, sir? Who's giving me the money? Huh? Please say something.
If only I had the money, I'd give it to you. I'm sorry. I'm not saying that I won't give it to you or that you should wait for years. let's just wait for a few months.
Did you just say a few months, Mr. Ho? You said a few days just a while ago, and now you're saying a few months?
She will rake in that much money just in a day when things get better. You know my mom. She's not the kind of person who can't afford that much.
A day? When is that day, sir? What is the point? A man dies and then you butcher a pig, a cow? What is the point of preparing a feast for a dead man?
Hey, just calm down. What's wrong with you? Look, you're not yourself.
Okay, I'm not myself! It's driving me crazy! Where is the medal?
God, are they all like you, North Korean defectors? You're just from a communist country and you love money that much? I'm sorry. I forgot we made you.
Sun heads up. Cho Mong Nan looks in the mirror.
Filthy bitch.
Ho Tae Young's studio apartment, Seoul, December. Cho Mong Nan and Ho Tae Young sit facing each other.
How am I supposed to find 50 million out of nowhere?
Move out of this apartment and give me the deposit.
Wow, look at you.
Look at you? Me? What's wrong with me?
Why are you doing this? You're freaking me out, okay?
You're freaking out? I am freaking out! I am the one who's scared to death! You're gonna move our old one.
How would I do that? This property has been seized already.
Where is your mother? I don't care how you do it, just give it to me, or you and I, we're gonna die here.
All right, let's just kill ourselves here. I don't wanna go on like this anyway.
You got paid for the film literature, right? 50 million won.
Wow, I don't know what to say.
Why do you make such a face? You stole the story about my grandmother, didn't you? You think I wouldn't know that you stole her story? Give me that money.
I haven't been paid yet.
Don't blow the bullshit trumpet and give me the money now.
I really haven't been paid
yet. Can't trust you, money!
Ho Tae-young calls Oh Young-kwan. Oh Young-kwan does not pick up. She leaves a voicemail.
Your phone is still off and I really need to talk to you. Please pick up the phone, I'm begging you.
She hangs up.
Why didn't you say anything about the money?
There's a good reason.
Call him again.
No.
Cho Mong Nan takes the hammer out.
Can't you see what I'm capable of? Do you want to die in my hands?
Ho Tae Young calls Oh Young Kwan again. Oh Young Kwan does not pick up, she leaves a voicemail.
Please pick up the phone. Please pick it up. Pick up the goddamn phone, you son of a bitch! I saw the premiere date on the internet. How could you do this to me, huh? Written and directed by Oh Young-kwan? I didn't even get a co-writer credit. I don't care about the Emmy credit. I don't care about the 50 million won, but how could you do this to me, huh? How can you just abandon me like this, you bastard? You son of a bitch!
Oh Young-kwan in a tuxedo appears upstage. He has a trophy in his hands, a barrage of camouflages.
First of all, I would like to thank the 15 million mover affection for the real Moon-on, the North Korean woman. Although I rejoice at the success of the film, I cannot help but think about the fact that the peninsula is still divided into the north and south. The pain of the divide reverberated far away in the Vietnam War, and it is still shared by us today and now. And I have a conviction that the reunion will approach us an inch by inch as we share this agony and continue to ruminate on it.
Ho Tae-young's studio apartment, Seoul, December. Ho Tae-young and Cho Mok-nan are lying side by side.
I used to dream of going to a warm southern beach. When I was younger, I wanted to go to Jeju Island. I wanted to see Hanyas diving in the blue ocean. Hand in hand with my comrades, I wanted to frolic on a warm southern beach. There's a
place named Yanggangdo Haesan, near the Amur River. I was in the propaganda squad there. In Joseon, you can make your dream come true unless you served in the military. My mother was a dancer, and I wanted to be a musician. And one day, somebody came and claimed to be my father's friend and asked me to take his lunch for a few days. I didn't know anything, and I did as he asked me to do. The next day, my close comrade working for the security department came to the propaganda squad with a very pale face. A smuggler is dropping your name. Do you know the man? I could feel the sky collapsing. It wasn't just any smuggler, but a porcelain smuggler who sells Korea blue porcelain in South Joseon. My comrade told me that all of my family will be arrested as political prisoners. So the comrade said, if you want to save your family, you should disappear and erase your trace. Then she left. That was the only thing I could do.
What about your parents? Do you know their whereabouts?
I heard that they have been expelled from Pyongyang and that they are in Cheongju now.
You're safe.
I've been told that things are not easy for them.
And that's why you need the money. And you need it soon.
I wish you were dead.
50 million won. I'm so sorry.
Hodegang stands up and paces. He rushes towards her and hugs her tight. He kisses her passionately. He kneels in front of her.
Mongnan, stay with me. We should leave South Korea together. Let's leave the peninsula together. Let's just go as far away as we can from here. Canada, Australia, Africa. Just run away as far as we can.
What do you mean, Mr.
Hotegang stands up and takes a brown photo album from the...
What is that?
50 million won. Let's send this money to the north and leave without any regrets. Yeah?
A van. Seoul, January. In a shabby van parked somewhere, Kim Jong-il at the driver's seat, Bae Myung-hee at the passenger seat, and Yoo Mong-nan at the back seat.
I knew this was gonna happen from the beginning. I just let it because you were making such a fuss about it.
I got it, so stop it.
Not a jot of blood was mixed. So how could we consider her our child?
I thought pity was more than enough to bind us.
Pity? Listen to yourself. You talk like a demented hag.
Well, I've never seen a girl like her. She just wouldn't say anything.
I haven't even heard her talk in her sleep.
You don't think she's become a mute, do you?
Who knows? There are people who are born normal, then one day, they can't speak anymore.
Didn't she speak fine at the detention center?
Yep, right. She used to sing well, too. Oh, there she comes.
Jo Mong-nan gets in the back seat. She has sunglasses on.
Wow, I almost didn't recognize you.
Great, look at you. You look like a regular jet setter. That's the way to go.
Who could possibly tell that you're heading all the way to Pyongyang?
Oh, shut that mouth.
I assume everything's set.
Don't worry a thing.
Kim Jong-il hands a document envelope to Jo Mong-nan. Jo Mong-nan puts the passport and documents into a secure place.
Oh, here we go.
Who's she?
Nobody.
We're just gonna drop her in Incheon before we cross the border. Oh, and by the way, you two have the same name.
That's true.
Her name is Mok Ran Tu, Yoo Mong-nan.
What a coincidence.
Is she also from Pyongyang?
Yes. We met her in Burma, at a refugee camp.
Her father was caught at the border and her mother died in the camp.
Her mother died just a week before she was supposed to come to South Korea. What a pity.
Where has she been since then?
You won't believe it. Now this hussy insisted that we should keep her, at least just for a few months.
Where does she have it to?
You know, to where she used to be.
Where else would she go? She's going back to the facility.
Yu Meng Nan wakes up. Zhou Meng Nan turns her head back towards the window. Spring, Canadian Embassy, Seoul, March. Ko Tae-gong is being interviewed for immigration.
Okay. The capital is Ottawa. El símbolo du Canada es fédéral. There are four seasons like South Korea. I have been to Vancouver to travel. Ainsi que pour étudier mon français. First, I will look for a place to live. Then, I will look for a job as I master the languages. Why do I want to leave South Korea? Pourquoi? Je veux... Hello!
Secretary's office at a Korean conglomerate company. Seoul, March.
So, you want more drama and pizzazz, right?
Yeah! Who's so glad you understand that?
And I suppose the president doesn't have any time to give me a voice recording?
No, he doesn't.
Well, I don't have enough source materials, but I guess it will have to do.
Are you sure?
I'm a novelist, so I shall write a novel.
Wonderful.
Writing things that didn't happen as if it happened is not easy. Writing things that didn't occur as if it occurred is not easy. Writing things that did happen, that did occur. Who can't do that?
Amazing. I can't wait till I read it.
Right. Could you perhaps add a zero, please?
Pote-san studio apartment. Seoul, March. Jyotitsa is lying down under a comforter. Pote-san is reading. Jyotitsa rises. She drinks rice wine from the bottle.
What are you reading?
The history of shit and piss.
You have the sleeping pills, right?
No. Just go to sleep.
Tae-san.
What?
Son, would you like to die with your mom today?
Sleep. We have to be on the run again tomorrow. Look at me. Hands on your stomach. Legs straight. Eyes shut. Lips closed. Empty your mind and tell yourself everything is fine. Everything is fine. Everything is fine.
Pote-san picks up the accordion. He presses a key. Last scene. One day, someday. Far away on the stage, Jo Sun-ho is painting Kim Il-sung's portrait still with his back towards the audience. Pote-san plays accordion downstage. There are Korean history books piled up beside him. Between the two, there is nothing but the hammer. From stage left, there comes a faint melody of guitar from a red light district in China. The woman playing guitar raises her head. The lights get brighter. She is in a black bikini top and a glittering maxi skirt with a long slit. Zhou Meng-nan sings the labyrinth of love in Chinese.
Long song long.
From stage right, Yoo Mong-nan walks in. She browses the stage. And then looks at the hammer. As Yoo Mong-nan steps towards the hammer, her small shadow is elongated. A curtain.
Join us for a little short discussion about the play. Would you come up, the writer, director, and translator? How do you know each other, and how come you were interested in directing the play?
Oh yeah, so Dialogue is a friend of mine that I met.
Can you all hear? Is that loud enough? Yeah. Okay. We all have to speak a little bit louder, so we don't have mic, because it sounds a little bit too loud, but then it's right.
So Dialogue is a friend of mine that I know through a mutual friend, and so we just connected as a fellow Korean theater director in the city, and I had the chance to direct the scene for one of Dialogue's classes. As a dramaturgy student at Columbia. And it was the scene where Hwang Tae-san and Jo Mong-nan are, they first speak, and they're sort of like connecting over these like automatic words that exist both in North and South Korea. And I thought,
so tell us a bit, where does this play come from?
Such a reading.
생각해 보면 그 한반도 미래에 이제 북쪽이랑 어쨌든 통일돼서 같이 살아야 되는데 그것의 작은 실험이라고 생각이 되는데요. 사실은 잘 지내지 못하고 있어요. 그래서 잘 지내지 못하고
became a reality for South Koreans, for many South Koreans, and the hope is that you know, they will be able to get along and find the living together or find a way to live together, but the reality of it is not necessarily that, and he wrote this play as possibly an experiment of exploring the possibility of how they are trying to live together.
Yeah, I see. We had this afternoon. We had plays from Palestine and from Syria. And Marvin Kaltz made the point that we speak about Arab theater, but it's so complex. There's so many layers, so many communities, and especially here, you see, it's one country, and you know they're just divided. But how complicated and how complex the reality really is. So the question for him is, how is it related to his life and his experience, or his family, or friends? How personal is the story?
Eso, con el comienzo de la gente, 그들의 시각에 비친 한국 사회의 모습이 되게 흥미로웠어요. 네. 그래서 사실은 한국 사회에서 잘 살아가지 못하고 있는 지식인들 그리고 시민 자본과 내려가는 어떤 그 경제적 상황들 뭐 이런 것들 여러 가지 한국 문제를 한국 사회를 어렵게 살아가고 있는 한국적 시선으로 그려 내고자 했습니다.
Just to clarify what I translated earlier, when he said that he's going to write about Jomunam, he did not mean Jomunam. When I said that he wanted to write about Jomunam, I didn't mean that he interviewed Jomunam as a real person, but he wanted to write about the fictional character of Jomunam after meeting the literary character. So just wanted to clarify that a little bit. And he was also saying that through his interview, he found their stories very interesting, that they were telling the stories about how they are not fitting into the story of Korean society. And as he was doing this research, he found it really interesting. The other side of the story that he found really interesting was the ways in which that their story is actually parallel with those who are South Koreans, who grew up in South Korea, the intellectuals who are actually also having a hard time, not just financially, but also culturally and politically. So in those stories, he found a parallel, so he wanted to explore that a little bit, and he found also, he also wanted to write the story about South Korea, or he wrote the story about South Korea through the perspectives of those Koreans who got there out.
Certainly also a story that touches on capitalism, on money, on dreams, on family, hopes, and many things. I'm from Germany, so we had East German defectors living in West Germany, and West Germans going to East Germany. Now the wall is down, and still the wall is up in the head, so a great theme. And not to the translation, you did a wonderful job by saying it words like air raid ban and others. So how did you juggle all this, and what were your challenges?
So the source text was actually difficult for me to understand without footnote, because North Korean dialect is very different from South Korean.
So it's written really in North Korean dialect. Yeah.
Yes, and that's actually how Sister Mona is distinguished from other literature, Korean literature talking about North Korean refugees, because some of them do not employ North Korean dialects. But here, on top of that, we have this character, Cho Daeja, the room salon madame, who speaks in a very coded language. So I had to navigate and negotiate between how to domesticate, or the boundary between domesticating and exotifying the language, because there's just so much politics around it. South Koreans, or Koreans in general, are others here. And North Korean characters in this play, they are also authorized by South Korean characters in the play. So if I exotify their language too much, then they will be doubly authorized, if that would make any sense. So that was something I had to do. I was walking on a tightrope.
Yeah, so one could feel that in the highly crafted and abstract language of Silva, so vitally strong, and I think, you heard from the audience reactions that not only the hammer, but also the interactions, But for the direction, how did it feel to do this play with that cast? I assume they're all from New York City living here. How do they, most probably many of them grew up here, how do they react to it? Could they connect to that idea, or was it as strange as a play from the Arab world, or from France, or from South Africa?
Yeah, I mean, among the cast, we have a mix of backgrounds. Some people are Korean American or Asian Americans, but we do also have cast members who are from Korea, and myself included. And so it was really interesting for me. Actually, the interesting parallel for me that Dayang and I discussed in that obsession with success and money that we are accustomed to as Western people. And so I tried to bring that out in my direction and also try to, it was like a bad, there was a lot of not only linguistic translation, but cultural translation happening between me and Dayang and between me and the actors in the room about, okay, well, this joke makes sense in the Korean language because of this, but we can't literally transfer that, so let's come up with like a new joke that makes sense in this context.
I thought it was wonderful to see the cast, the full cast of Korean actors or Korean American actors. I mean, often maybe our Pinball Voices readings, we have a play from Pakistan or from India, where we really have full cast, and the theme is actually not being, you know, one of those minor characters who often do come up in plays written in the Americas or in Europe, but it's really about this theme. To watch them, I could only imagine how it would be if they would work together and do plays. But yes?
Some of the actors actually were not.
Yeah, sorry. They convinced me. Yeah, tell me, what are your thoughts about the
Well, I actually have a few questions. But I think we have to speed along. So I just want to read one thing that I found really interesting. I'll read it. We heard it, but Huttingan says, thus spoke Ingeborg Bachmann. To avoid separation, each of us would sense the schism. In the shared void, we should feel the same slash. And I'll just skip down. Possessed by nostalgia, we will cross over the boundary and we will create one harmony with all places. And then the interesting thing is that you didn't get to hear is the translator.
A sentence that has a little bit of a lofty idea. So he was looking
four quotes that you could use for that scene that specifically dealt with borders. And he stumbled upon that poem, and he said, you know, he decided to use it. But he also thought that line where it says, everyone has to find the vision in their own space, which is the only hope for having a solidarity. He could sort of latch onto throughout the play, so that's that.
Mia, I think you just caught that she was paraphrasing.
She translated the poem differently from how I did.
So Korean language and English language are just so wildly different.
Yeah.
For example, the sentence structure is not subject verb objective; it's subject verb subject object and then verb, which makes it very difficult for an interpreter to simultaneously interpret what in some sense to you. And for me, main difficulty in translating this play was finding something that would be parallel to North Korean dialect. Because in the original, in the source text, we see three different North Korean dialects. And we also see, I cannot remember the number exactly, but around like five different South Korean dialects. So at first I was playing with ideas like, should I find a parallel in English dialects? For example, should I replace Pyongyang dialect with Scottish accent? But for me, that doesn't make any sense because Scottish accent has a completely different implication for American audience here as opposed to what North Korean or Pyongyang dialect might mean for Seoul audience. So what I aimed to do, hopefully, was to find the equivalent effect that was intended for a South Korean audience in my translation so that it would have similar effect for American audience.
So I have another question. So I've been reading about how playwrights in Korea have been struggling with government censorship in recent years. And I'm just wondering, how has that impacted you? So.
Okay. 이게 며칠 전에도 이제 그 검열 문제 사태 이렇게 사태 이렇게 연극인들 비상 그 대책 모임 있어요. 그 모임을 나가서 회의하고 왔고요. 그리고 뭐 바로 또 며칠 전에는 국립극단에서 작가들이 한 검열 문제가 좀 있어가지고 그것에 대해서 이제 단장과 프로듀서가 나가지고 연극인들과 좌담하는 그런 자리가 있었거든요. 진정 국면으로 이제 들어가고 있는 것 같고요. 단지 연극뿐만 아니라 지난 뭐 이명박 박근혜 정부에서는 정부가 이렇게 예술을 지원하는 공공 자금을 가지고 그 예술가들을 통제할 수 있다는 환상에 사로잡혀 있었어요. 굉장히 말도 안 되는 일들이 벌어졌었고요. 굉장히 그래서 많은 사건들이 있었고 여러 가지 상처들이 있는데 그런 것들을 잘 치료해 가야 되는 그런 시간이 많이 걸릴 것 같습니다.
So things are still ongoing. A few days before he left for New York, there was a meeting among the theater makers in Korea to discuss how the action plans or how to deal with the current situation, and when he goes back, you know, there will be another meeting with the group of theater makers, and additionally, there was another meeting with the National Theater of Korea, which also is involved. There was a conversation between the president of the NTOK, National Theater of Korea, and the theater makers as well to try to figure things out together. And he's saying that they are trying to work together to better the situation a little bit, but the bigger issue is that under the previous government, or the previous administration and the one before, the government was under the fantasy that they could use the government money or the tax money to influence and force the arts to their benefit. So that's the culture that they are involved, that they have to work against. So that's a long, sort of a long road ahead, but they are trying to work it out.
We have time for one more question.
Okay, I have one question for Sujit. I know that you, born and raised in Korea, and I'm sure you've, it sounds like you've done a lot of collaboration with Korean artists, but you've also had a lot of theater education in the US. Mm-hmm. And so I'm just wondering, what can we borrow from each other? You're in a really great position to tell us, what can US theater makers learn from South Korean theater and vice versa?
I actually wanna see if Dion wants to.
Oh,
we can kind of do it together,
yeah.
I haven't had that much experience working
right,
in Korea.
Right.
I've had some experience working with Korean artists, but I kind of want to like share the mic, because, yeah.
Well, to be honest, I didn't exactly have theater education in South Korea either, because I was studying English literature. But obviously, the theater system is really different from that of the United States, because as you have heard from us, South Korean theater is subsidized by the government. In South Korea, I actually have some better people to talk about this issue in the cast. Like, I can't find Sunhee. The actor who played Moonan, I don't know where she is, over there, hiding.
I mean, I think that
but
one thing I will say is, I think in my very small experience, I've been really impressed by the athleticism and the physicality that's in this play, and that is in the, I did some work with this Korean company named Mokpa, which is a really famous company in Korea for their amazing physical adaptations of Shakespeare that's infused with Korean traditional forms, and so I've been really amazed by some of the how disciplined actors bodies are, and what magic they create with their bodies, and how I feel like in this country at least, it's like living room plays are easier to produce, and so I feel like sometimes bigger epic plays like this one kind of get shoved in a drawer somewhere, if they're unproducible, and it's just easier to have two people talking, which can be great. But every time I go and see a play at home or meet a new Korean theater company, I feel I'm always impressed by physical virtuosity.
Before we go to the bar and have our goodbye to the entire festival, a last comment from Unsom Kim. How did it feel to listen to the reading in the American audience and here in New York? What would you feel?
역시나 기분이 좋진 않네요. 그러니까 지난 몇 년 전에 일본에서 방송을 했을 때도 기분이 좀 묘했었는데 그런 기분이 들고요. 괜한 공명심이 아니라 언젠가 기회가 된다면 되게 좋은 밝은 한반도 이야기를 가지고 다시 이렇게 뉴욕 관객들과 만날 수 있게 된다면 좋겠습니다. 긴 시간 감사합니다.
So before he came over here, another production of Sister Moonan just concluded a few days ago, and he found it was really interesting. When he points at which the Korean audiences responded were similar to the points at which the New York audiences responded. So we found it really interesting. He doesn't feel entirely at ease and comfortable bringing this particular play to New York audience. It is a story about the separation of the two countries, a separation of the family, or the divisions that exist within the family. So he felt similarly when he brought this play to Japan a few years back, and he hopes that one day, someday, he will be able to bring a play about Korea that deals with a little more happy or a little more upbeat and positive. That paints a little more positive picture of South Korea and Korea as a whole. And thank you so much for coming and sitting through for this.